Good morning, class. Today we are going to learn about the multiplication and division of rational numbers. See here, multiplication and how division, how to perform in the case of rational number. Don't worry, it is not different than multiplication and division of fraction, same like that. Okay, see here, first example is 3 upon 25 into 10 upon 9. As the process of multiplication we have done in the case of fraction, same here. Multiply numerator with numerator and denominator with denominator. And if we can find the lowest term, we have to do that. Okay. See here. Your first step will be multiply numerator with numerator. 3 into 10 upon denominator multiply with denominator. 3 into 10 upon 25 into 9. Now here we have to find the lowest term. We can reduce this by dividing both numerator and denominator by their common factor. For example, here see 3 and 9. 3 in the numerator and 9 in the denominator. They have common factor 3. So let us divide both of them by 3. Here if you divide these 3 by 3, 3 ones are 3, 3 threes are 9. Further, 10 and 25, they also have common factor 5, correct? So, let us divide both of them by 5. 5 2s are 10 and 5 5s are 25. So, 2 into 1, 2. 3 into upon 3 into 5, 15. So, 2 upon 15 is your answer. Okay? Next example, minus 3 upon 4 multiply by minus 8 upon 15. Here also multiply numerator with numerator, minus 3 into minus 8 upon 4 into 15. And here you have to think that any numerator and denominator can be divided by their common factor. So see here 3 and 15, they have common factor 3. So if you divide minus 3 by 3, you will get minus 1. And here 3 5s are, correct? 15. And here 4 1s are 4, 4 2s are, that is minus 2, okay? And then minus 1 into minus 2, minus 1 into minus 2, 2 1s are 2 and minus into minus plus, so plus 2 upon 5 1s are 5, so 2 upon 5. So this is what multiplication of rational number. In this way, we can do the multiplication of rational number. Then see here, these two examples are based on the division. Now you know that in the case of fraction we have done, we have performed the division of fractions, and we have seen that division means what? Nothing but division of fraction means nothing but multiplication by the reciprocal of second fraction. Here also same. What we have to do? 1 upon 8, first rational number, right? As it is, instead of division, right, the sign of multiplication and reciprocal of second fraction. Now reciprocal means what? 2 upon 9. It is also called multiplicative inverse. Multiplicative inverse means the number in the denominator will go in the numerator and vice versa. Okay, so here reciprocal of 9 upon 2 is 2 upon 9. Understood what we have done? Now this example, it becomes an example of multiplication. So all remaining steps we have to perform in this way, like multiplication. Okay. So 1 into 2 upon 8 into 9. So see here, 2 1s are 2, 2 4s are 8. Okay. 1 into 1, 1 and 9 4s are 36. 1 upon 36 is the answer. So division of rational number is nothing but multiplication by the reciprocal of the second rational number. Okay, this. Next, minus 2 integer 1 by 3 divided by 3 integer 3 by 4. These are mixed rational number. First, let us convert them into improper, and then we have to go by as these steps. Okay, 3 2s are 6. Plus 1, 7, that is minus 7, because minus sign is there. Remember, this minus sign belongs to this 2 also and 1 by 3 also, okay? So, this here became minus 7, 3 into minus 2, minus 6, minus this one, that is minus 6 minus 1 minus 7 upon 3 divided by 3 4 are 12 plus 3 15 upon 4. Okay, now minus 7 upon 3 divided by 15 upon 4 means multiply by reciprocal of 15 upon 4. So write here multiplication sign and 4 upon 15. Got it? Now as usual, is there any numerator denominator divisible by the common factor? No, that's why. Multiply this. Minus 7 into 4 minus 28 and 15 threes are 45. Okay, this is your answer. So in this way, we can do the multiplication and division of the rational number. Pause this video, write these four examples with the name of the concept, write these four examples in notebook, and after that we will see the properties of multiplication and division in the case of rational number. Okay, now see here, properties of multiplication of rational numbers. See, when we have learned the addition and subtraction of rational number, we have seen some properties like closure property, commutative property, associative property. Okay, so same properties are there in the multiplication, and we have to check whether those properties are applicable for multiplication of rational number or not. Okay, see here, whole properties I have written: closure property, commutative property, associative property, and one more special property is there for the multiplication, that is distributive property. Okay, what is that? We will explain it. Now see, first closure property. What we have seen in the addition, if two rational numbers are added, the answer is also rational number. If we have added two rational numbers, their answer is also rational number that we have obtained. That means rational numbers are closure under addition, and rational numbers are closure under subtraction also. Let us see, are rational numbers closure under multiplication? That means if we add, if we multiply two rational numbers, the answer which we will get, the product which we will get, is it also rational number? That we have to check. Let us see, let us take one example. See here, for example, A upon B into C upon D, if these are two rational numbers and these two rational numbers are multiplied, then answer is also rational number. That is what the closure property says. So let us check with an example. For example, 3 upon 25 into 3 upon 25 into 5 upon 18. Okay, these are two rational numbers, 3 upon 25 into 5 upon 18. So let us multiply them. If their answer, if their product or answer is also rational number, that means rational numbers are closure under multiplication. So let us see here, 3 into 5 upon 25 into 18. Here 3 ones are 3, 3 6 are 18, 5 ones are 5, 5 5s are 25, and 1 into 1, 1, 5 6 are 30, 1 upon 30. So 1 upon 30, is it rational number 1 upon 30? Is it in the form of P upon Q, where Q is not equal to 0? Yes. 1 upon 30 is also rational number. That means if we multiply two rational numbers, it gives rational number. So we can say that rational numbers are closure under multiplication. Okay. Second property is commutative property. So we have seen that commutative property and associative property, these two properties are based on the order of the numbers, sequence of the numbers. Here, what commutative property says, A upon B and C upon D, these are two rational numbers. Then, A upon B multiplied by C upon D is same as C upon D into A upon B. Means, if we change the sequence in multiplication, if we change the sequence of rational number, we get the product equal, we get the product same. Okay, let us check with the example. Two rational numbers are there, 3 into 25, 3 upon 25 into 5 upon 18. So their answer we get, we have found that 1 upon 30. If we change the sequence of the rational number, if we change the order of the rational number, what happens? Let us check. Or is it going to affect on the product? 5 into 3,
18 into 25. What do you think? Is it going to affect on the answer, product? Obviously, no, because though we change the order of the rational numbers, the product remain same. That means yes, rational numbers are commutative under multiplication. Okay. Same for the associative property. If three or more rational numbers are there and we have to multiply them, can we change their order? Can we change their order according to our convenience? Can we change their order? That associative property says this. Okay, so here suppose three rational numbers are there, a upon b into c upon d into e upon f, a upon f. Okay, so if you multiply this first two rational number, instead of multiplying all three together, if you multiply these two, okay, and third one multiply later in that product, then is equal to a upon b into c upon d into a upon f. Means if you multiply first two rational number and in their product, if we multiply third one, the product which we will get here, it will be equal to the this. Means if you multiply last two rational numbers and in that product, we will multiply first rational number. So product in these two cases, which we will get here, it will be same. Okay, let us check the example. 3 upon 25 into 5 upon 18 into one more number, let us take 1 by 4. So what will be their product? First we will multiply these two and their answer is we have got 1 by 30. So 1 by 30 into 1 by 4. In this product of these two rational numbers, we have multiplied 1 by 4 with that product. Okay. So what do we get? 1 1s are 1 and 34s are 120. Okay. Now, instead of multiplying these two numbers first, we will multiply second, last two rational numbers. Okay. 3 upon 25 into 5 upon 18 into 1 by 4. So these two rational numbers we will multiply first and we will check whether the product gets different or same. So 3 upon 25 into 5 ones are 5 and 18 fours are 72. Fine. Now see, 5 ones are 5, 5 fives are 25, 3 ones are 3, 3 ones are 3, 3 twos are 24. Okay. 324 is 72. So 1 into 1 1 and 24 5 is 120. See, 1 upon 120, 1 upon 120. Product remains same. Though the order of rational number is changed. That means if you multiply 3 or more rational numbers, if you multiply in any order, their product do not change. Their product remain equal, same. This is what associative property tells us. Then next property is distributive property. This is very important property in the case of multiplication of rational numbers. Okay, pay attention very carefully. This is very important property. See here. So a distributive property. We have seen this property in the case of whole number, distribution of whole number over addition and subtraction. Okay, see here. If three rational numbers are there and they have given in this form, a upon b multiplied by in bracket c upon d plus e upon f, where there is addition of two rational numbers and a upon b is multiplied with this. Okay, then what happens? These two rational numbers in the bracket are distributed with the a upon b. That is, a upon b multiplied by a upon b multiplied by c upon b, a upon b multiplied by c upon b plus a upon b multiplied by e upon f, second rational number. So this, the two rational numbers in the bracket can be distributed in this way. Okay, a upon b multiplied by in bracket c upon b plus e upon f is equal to a upon b into c upon d plus a upon b into e upon f. or this opposite also, vice versa, means if any example is given in this form, a upon b into c upon d plus a upon b into e upon f, means a upon b, it is common, then these common rational numbers can be taken out, multiplied by in bracket c upon d plus e upon f. Okay? When the example is given in this form, we can distribute it in this way, or if example is given in this form, we can sum up in this way. Okay? Let us give an example. For example, 1 by 4 into in bracket 16 upon 5 plus 12 upon 3. So this can be solved in this way, is equal to 1 by 4 into 16 upon 5 plus 1 by 4 into 12 upon 3. Understood? It becomes easy. Why? Because instead of adding this, if you multiply these two numbers in the bracket by 1 by 4, example becomes easy. In which way? See, 4 1 is 4, 4 4 is 16. Here 4 1 is 4, 4 3 is 12. We got here 4 1 is 4 upon 5 plus 3 1 is 3 upon 3. So here it is easy. 12 plus 15 upon 15. So 12 plus 15 27 upon 15, which is equal to 3 9 and 27, 3 5 9 upon 5. Okay, understood? So this is what distributive property tensors. Okay, so we have seen that all these four properties are applicable here in the multiplication. Okay, let us see two more properties. There are not properties actually, but they are facts. So let us see, if we multiply any rational number by 1, if we multiply any rational number by 1, what answer we will get? Yes, that number itself. So the identity of that rational number do not change. Okay, answer we get that number itself. That's why the 1 is called, or 1 is called the multiplicative identity or identity element of the rational multiplication of rational number. As we have seen, 0 is the identity element for the addition of rational number, because if you add 0 in any rational number, answer is that rational number itself. Similarly, here in the multiplication, if you multiply any rational number by 1, the answer is that rational number itself. That's why the 1 is called multiplicative identity for the rational number. Whereas another property we can say it is, if you multiply any rational number by 0, if you multiply any rational number by 0, 1 by 2 into 0, what answer will you get? 0 itself. Or 0 multiplied by any rational number, answer is 0 itself. Okay? And the another property we can say, 1 by 2 multiplied by 2 by 1. 1 by 2 multiplied by 2 by 1. Means what answer will you get? 1, correct? So see here, 1 by 2 multiplied by 2 by 1. It is called multiplicative inverse or reciprocal of this 1 by 2. If you multiply any rational number by its reciprocal, what answer do we get? 1. Okay? So this reciprocal of the rational number is also called multiplicative inverse. What? Multiplicative inverse. Then in the addition we have seen additive inverse. Understood? Additive inverse means opposite number. If the rational number is positive, its additive inverse is negative. And if we add those additive inverse, we get answer 0. Here we get answer 1. By multiplying rational number and its multiplicative inverse, that is reciprocal, we get answer 1. Okay? So these four properties which are very important to write in the note. Let us see now properties for the division of rational numbers. Here there are only three properties for the division of rational numbers. See, first property, closure property. We have seen that closure property is applicable in the addition, subtraction and multiplication also. Here closure property is applicable for the division also, but there is one condition. What is that condition?
See here, if A upon B and C upon D are two rational numbers, then A upon B divided by C upon D is equal to rational number. But this C upon D is a known divisor. It should not be equal to 0. C upon D should not be equal to 0, because we cannot divide any number by 0. You know that we cannot divide any number by 0. This number first dividend can be 0. 0 divided by any number, it is possible, but any number divided by 0 is not possible. That's why here it is given that C upon D, it should not be 0. Then only rational numbers are closure under division. Okay, all non-zero rational number, set of all non-zero rational numbers are closure under division. Okay, for example, see here, if you take two rational numbers, 4 upon 5 divided by 4 upon 5, 8 upon 15. Then what happens here? 4 upon 5 divided by means multiplied by reciprocal of the second, that is 15 upon 8. So here 4 1s are 4, 4 2s are 8, 5 1s are 5, 5 3s are 15. Answer is 3 1s are 3, 2 1s are 2. So 3 upon 2. And 3 upon 2 is a rational number. That means rational numbers are closure under division except zero. Okay. Property of 1. What property of 1 says? If you divide any rational number by 1, the answer is that rational number itself. Or if you divide any rational number by negative of minus 1, the answer will be minus A upon B. Okay. For example, 4 upon 5 divided by 1, the answer is 4 upon 5 multiplied by, reciprocal of this one is 1 upon 1, reciprocal is same, 1 only, that's why it will be 4 upon 5 itself. Or 4 upon 5 divided by minus 1. So reciprocal of 4 upon 5 multiplied by reciprocal of minus 1 will be minus 1 upon minus 1, that is minus 1 itself. So 4 1 the 4 and 5 into minus 1 minus 5, so minus 4 upon 5. Okay, division by number itself means what? If A upon B is rational number, if you divide A upon B by itself, A upon B, then what will be the answer? 1. Okay, that is 4 upon 5 divided by 4 upon 5. The answer is 4 upon 5 multiplied by reciprocal, that is 5 upon 4. So 5, 5 cut, 4, 4 cut. Answer 1. That is, if any rational number divided by itself, the answer is 1. Okay. Or if it is negative, A upon B divided by minus A upon B, the answer will be minus 1. Okay. You can check by this example. So, write these three properties of division in the notebook. So, these are the properties of division, these three properties of division, and previous four we have seen properties of multiplication. Okay, so today's lecture we have discussed about multiplication and division of rational number and their properties. Okay, in the today write these, whatever I have written on the board, write in the notebook, and along with that I will give some examples to solve. You have to solve it. Okay. If you have any doubt in this, we will discuss during problem solving period. So thank you and have a nice day.